I wish you can see this leaf clearly. See this plant, it is called sandpaper tree. This is called sandpaper tree. You can see the sandpaper tree, you have a sandpaper leaf. I wish you can see it clearly. This is the tree here. You can see the tree, you can see the leaf. It's called sandpaper tree. In fact, this particular sandpaper tree and sandpaper leaf has numerous medicinal value in poultry and livestock. If you are a poultry farmer, both four-legged and feathered animals, in fact, go and plant this tree around your farm because of its numerous medicinal values. You can see it clearly well. I'm going to break one of the leaves so that I will go into an inclusive environment where you will clearly see it. Let me break one. Let me cut one of it. Let me cut one of it for you to see it very well. I have never seen a plant that can treat more than 300 different poultry infections like this particular tree. Let me cut it. See it? I'm cutting. This is one. You can see the tree here. See the tree here. Are you seeing it? You can see the tree here. This is the leaf. Now let's go into action to tell you the nutritional and medicinal value of this particular plant. Let's go there. Let me briefly describe this sandpaper plant for you to enable you understand how the leaf is and how it works. This is the sandpaper plant leaf. You can see it. I don't know whether you have an idea of how it looks like. In Yoruba land, this is called ipin. Ipin, I-P-I-N. Ipin in Yoruba land. This is the plant. You can see it. It is called sandpaper leaf because it is coarse in nature. It looks like sandpaper. The type of sandpaper furnitures or furniture makers use, the same sandpaper furnitures use. Now watch. You can see my finger here now. See how sandpaper works. Sandpaper leaf works. Watch now. I'm going to use it to sandpaper my finger now. You can see it now. Are you seeing my finger? Can you see it? To tell you how coarse this particular leaf is. This is to enable you identify it wherever you see it, either in the bush or near your house. The leaf is very coarse, like the same sandpaper furniture makers and metal makers use to sandpaper or to brush metals. This particular leaf is so coarse that you can even use it to sandpaper a wood. See my finger now. You can see my finger. How? See this finger now. You can see it now. Now let me sandpaper this for you to know how it works. Right now, you can see it. You see my finger now after sandpapering my finger with this particular leaf. Are you seeing it? Can you see the difference now? Are you seeing the difference? To tell you that it's very coarse in nature. So, wherever you see this leaf, for you to identify it, it is very coarse in nature. It looks like the normal sandpaper. You can see it. It's very coarse. Can you even hear the sound? You can hear the sound. This is sandpaper leaf. This particular leaf is highly medicinal. It is highly medicinal in poultry and livestock. If you are a four-legged poultry farmer, you rear goat, cow, sheep, and every other four-legged animals, rabbit, this leaf is good for you. Livestock and poultry animals eat this particular leaf. You can still use this leaf and add it to their feed. For example, poultry. You can air dry this particular leaf or dehydrate it with a machine and feed it to your poultry bed after crushing it. You can add it to their meal because it's very rich in vitamins like vitamin A, vitamin B, vitamin C, vitamin K. It has iron, it has magnesium, it has sodium, it has sulfur, and it has calcium.
All these minerals are good to boost the immune system and at the same time the growth and weight of your poultry birds. I'm talking about poultry here. Whatever I say about poultry, it is also generally inclusive in other four-legged animals like cow, sheep, goat, rabbit, guinea fowl, geese, and other birds. Both dog, any poultry and livestock animal can eat this. Let me drop it and let's go into the nutritional and medicinal value of this particular leaf. Now, listen. One, it treats liver disorder in poultry and livestock animals. If your poultry birds are having issues in digestive system, this particular leaf is highly medicinal. It can aid in correcting every kidney or liver disorder in poultry and livestock animals. For instance, if your poultry bird is dropping greenish poo, in fact, go and look for this leaf. Let me pick it again for you to see. Some of you will still ask questions. On this seed, let me use only one of it. You can see it clearly well. It is greenish in color. And it is very coarse in nature. Coarse in extent that you can use it to brush. You can use it to sandpaper. You can even use some paper, a pen. Just get a pen like this. Sandpaper it. Can see how? Are you seeing the difference now? You can see it. Use it on your finger. You can see the difference also. So that is how coarse nature of this particular leaf is. At the same time, it can also treat diarrhea. Forget about the greenish poo, which is prevalent with Newcastle disease infection. If your poultry birds are dropping greenish poo or is affected by Newcastle, go and look for this particular leaf, this sandpaper leaf right now, or Ipim in Yoruba land. Go look for it. Gather up to, if possible, 1 kg. You don't buy it. This is one of the reasons why this leaf is very important to you, because you don't buy it. It is planted in boundary, in land boundaries, in some villages and in some communities. They use it to demarcate between lands. They use it to demarcate lands and the owners of each land. It is always planted at the boundary section of the lands. So it is not, you don't buy it. It's not a leaf that you, it just, it's not like, it's not like ordinary edible leaves like green. It's not like pumpkin. It's not like other leaves that you can spend money. Don't spend money for this. And it has a lot of leaves that you can pluck. If possible, get a full 1 kg of this particular leaf. Either you dehydrate it with a dehydrator, or you air dry it and keep. Grind it properly well. It will serve you in liver and kidney disorder in poultry and livestock animals, most especially when they are dropping greenish poo. It can as well help in treating bacterial infections like coccidiosis. It can as well help in treating different infections, which I'm going to mention here for you to understand. Infections like E. coli, infections like chronic respiratory diseases. It can as well treat fowl cholera, necrotic enteritis. It can treat polluron diseases, fowl typhoid, polytosis. It can treat infection coryza. It can as well treat bacterial and intestinal tract infections. It can as well treat parasite infections or parasitic infections like worms, lice, mice, ticks in poultry and livestock. It can as well treat avian pores in poultry, infectious bronchitis. It can treat Newcastle. It can treat Marek diseases and infectious Brucey disease, popularly known as Gumboro disease. This particular leaf is highly medicinal in poultry and livestock. Please don't ever play with it. Now, in poultry, this particular leaf can treat respiratory infection. It can as well aid poultry and livestock animals, most especially when they are so weak, when they are too weak, when the infection have attacked them so much that they find it difficult to eat. You can blend this leaf, pound it or grind it, gather the extract, use the extract and give them in drinking water. You can inculcate it in their feed. Up to 1 kg for 100 kg of feed. 1 kg of this particular leaf can be added to their feed of up to 100 kg of feed. That is about 4 25 kg bags. you can use 1 kg of feed for 1,000 bears in drinking water. How do you do it? Gather them, wash it properly well, because it is a tree, it is a plant, it is a leaf you can get in the bush. So it is always dusty. It is always dusty and contaminated, maybe contaminated by bacteria. Therefore, it is very good and advisable for you to wash it properly well before blending it. Blend it properly well after washing. Use 10 liters of water for 1 kg of this leaf and serve it for 1,000 birds. I mean, please. 1 kg, use 10 liters of water. After blending or grinding or pounding, depending on the method, any method, or squeezing, any method you want, you feel it is convenient and comfortable for you to extract the juice from this particular sandpaper leaf, is also good. Dilute it with 1 full drinker of 10 kg or 10 liters. After diluting it, you know the quantity of water your 1,000 bears can take at a time. Serve it. Either you add extra water and serve it to make sure that each of those 1,000 bears partake in this. Do this for complete 5 days. In fact, you get a very good result that you even come back here to say thank you. It is also good in healing wounds in animals, most especially if there is cannibalism or fighting in between the livestock or bears or livestock animals, and that fight happened to create injury on their skin. This particular leaf is very good in healing of injuries. Very good in injury healing. It is also good for skin and every skin infection or feather infections. It helps to make their feathers glow. You see the very nice, you know, most of the times birds lose feathers, and most of the loss of feather is as a result of one lacking of one vitamin or mineral in their feed. This particular leaf will do what? Glow their skin and make their feather very neat and good. It also serves as antiparasites. As I earlier said, it can treat lice, it can treat mice, it can treat ticks in livestock and poultry. It can as well treat roundworms in poultry. Remember, when your poultry is affected with intestinal tract worms, they find it difficult to eat. And that worm causes what we call watery diarrhea. And watery diarrhea do what? Make the pen waterlogged and swampy in nature. And the swampiness of this particular pen will give rise to pathogens that will create or give advantage to coccidiosis infection. But when you use this particular leaf, it's going to handle that particular diarrhea and rectify their body system and give them a very good, healthy looking. It's also good in as an analgesic. That is, when they are having painful bones, when they find it difficult to move, in short. Remember, there are times due to spraddle leg, due to bone injuries, and lack of calcium in their, or inadequate calcium in their poultry feed, most of these birds find it difficult to walk around. This particular leaf has a very good substantial amount of calcium in it. It has vitamins, it has minerals that help to strengthen their bones. For egg-laying birds, this particular leaf is very good because it helps to strengthen the quality of the egg and at the same time boost the egg size. If you are an egg or layers farmer, look for this leaf right now. If your birds are finding it difficult to lay on time, give them this leaf extract for 5 days. You will see that they will lay at the appropriate time. In fact, you start expecting their eggs even before the 18th week. I know that most laying birds start from 16th week. But if you give them this, you are going to see up to 50% startup laying process in their poultry layers. Another one, it helps in treatment of different diarrhea, both greenish, reddish, watery diarrhea, brownish diarrhea. All these are also handled or managed or controlled by this particular leaf, this sandpaper leaf. Wherever you see it, go and cut the stem and plant it around your farm. It is highly medicinal. It has minerals. It has vitamins. Enough to handle and boost the immune system of your poultry birds. In fact, if you are an organic poultry farmer, you are not using synthetic vaccines, this particular leaf serves as an immune booster. It boosts the immunity against every viral, bacterial, parasite, and fungal infections. It also helps to strengthen and fortify them against any of these infections. Instead of spending much on synthetic vaccination, go and look for this leaf. Use it at a startup to boost their immunity instead of wasting or spending much on the synthetic vaccines. The leaf is not only highly medicinal. They pack something like this. Go and peel the skin of the tree like this. You see it like this? Boil it with 10 liters of water for up to 30 minutes. Allow it to cool and serve it to your birds. It's also highly medicinal as of the leaf. The bark, the leaf, and the roots of this particular, if you can dig the roots of this particular plant also, wash it properly well and cut it into pieces, boil it for up to 30 minutes, and serve it to your poultry birds. It will handle all these infections I've earlier mentioned for you here. I'll still repeat them any more and more. E. coli, CRD, fowl cholera, necrotic arthritis, fowl typhoid, roundworms, infectious coryza, lice, mice, ticks, and avian pores, and other infectious bronchitis, Newcastle, and infectious brucei. All the diseases, both viral, fungal, parasite, and bacterial infections can be handled by this particular leaf. I've never seen any leaf or any plant. All my researches I've been doing for the past years that serve well in poultry and livestock than this sandpaper leaf. No wonder the leaf is very, very coercive in nature. No wonder people run away, because if the leaf touches your skin will eventually peel off. No wonder people run away. And no wonder all the good things are hidden in difficult plants. If you see all those plants that are not friendly with our skins, they are highly medicinal. I'm going to treat more of them and you see why I made this statement right now. If this video is very interesting to you and you have found or gained knowledge on this, allow this video to reach others. You know how you can make it to reach others. Let those that need this video, those that are interested in poultry farming, those are interested in organic farming, let them get this particular knowledge you have gotten right now. Till I come with another interesting topic in the same organic. Bye. Please. We'll see you next time. Bye for now.